Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome to episode 26 of my The Last of Us Let's Play on the PlayStation 3. When we last left off, Joel and Ellie were exploring the University of Eastern Colorado looking for some fireflies, who were supposedly still in the area. Now let's continue with chapter number 8, The University.
Oh no. Oh no indeed. Alright, so Ellie's gonna stay over there behind the gate on Canker Sword.
Someone jerry-rigged this thing.
Wall panel note.
No juice.
What does the note say? It probably mentioned something about juice. Apple, orange, power, you know, they're
see
all good.
Get the power back on.
Wall panel note, let's check it out. We had to rig up the door to the generator upstairs. Please use it sparingly as we're running out of gas. Great. Great. Do you think one thing in the future you'd have plenty of? It's people's fats and methane. Nope. Running out of that too. We have also inadvertently, or perhaps vertently, I don't, is vertently a word? We have locked off the last section of the game. So if I wanted to go back to that desk and upgrade some more weapons, I can't. Once that gate was closed on Ellie, we, also close the book on that first beginning of this chapter. You can't do a lot of backwards exploration in this game. It's kind of one way only. Oh, Jesus Christ! I only have a couple of hits with this bad boy. Oh, Jesus. Run! Run, Joel! Alright. I have a new flamethrower. Let's see if it works. The stupid... infected monsters! I'm putting you out of your misery. Just die.
That's that.
And that's that. I thought these were all clickers. I was gonna sneak up on them. I forgot they could see me. Oops! It's alright. I got to use my new flamethrower. Pick up some ammunition for it, as well as had an opportunity to use that machete, which is one of my favorite. Items in the entire game. You get those sweet decapitations. Decapitated! Unstoppable! What else do we have here? I just jumped through this window twice. I'm an idiot. Okay. Nothing, 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 nothing. Ooh, something! Such a nice day in Eastern Colorado University. You know, if I was still of college age, I would attend this school. It seems nice. Nestled in the Rocky Mountains. Hey, look, a giant building that looks like a mirror. It's so pleasant here. You know, minus all the infected that are trying to eat your face off in between classes, but how is that different from any other college? At regular colleges, they just call that tuition. Oh, it's true. I paid a lot of money to go to school. Okay, well, where's that bloody generator? Where's the bloody generator?
Hey, I was thinking I would want to be an astronaut.
That's a fact.
Yeah. That would have been cool. I'm just saying.
I think everybody wanted to be an astronaut at one point or another. Okay, let me just follow the cable, because I clearly was not paying attention the first time. Oh, it's right. I walked right between it. It just was under the desk. I did not see it at all. That's all right. Oh, jeez. I'm not very good at this. It's just like real life when I try to start my lawnmower. I used to be terrible at it. Although I think a good deal of it was that we bought it used, it was 20 years old, and had a bad start to begin with. I recall many an afternoon my father and I would be out in the backyard on a hot July afternoon just flipping that lawnmower over, trying to take it apart and fix the engine and... That is the extent of my mechanical skills, is attempting to fix a lawnmower. I think we did temporarily, but it was notoriously unreliable. Da-da-da-da!
What'd you want to be?
Well, when I was a kid, I used to want to be a singer.
What?
Shut up.
I'm serious.
No way.
Say something.
No.
Come on, I won't laugh.
I didn't know you'd do anything creative.
Joel, please.
Melissa Smith Library. And yes, Hotshot, you are correct. Very astute observation. that last little reference I dropped was Woody Allen doing Marty McFly in Back to the Future 1. Get out of town. I didn't know you did anything creative. Woody Allen doing Marty McFly. I think it's a pretty solid impression, actually, if I do say so myself. I agree. Thank you, Howard. So, I mean, there's that. Where are we going? Oh, ha ha ha. We're going up this way. Wait, what was that? It was a glimmer. It was something in the distance. Cankersaw, why can't... All right, well, Cankersaw can't go over that way. So, clearly not the place we need to be at. Da 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 da. Alright, you stay whore. You stay whore. Your horse. Here. Horse. What? Did I just call it... I think I just called Cankersaw a whore. That's alright. I'm sure he's fucked a lot of other horses. He? Him? Her? I don't even know. Wow, look at this. All this talk about prostitution has got me excited. Even more so because now we have in possession Alex Rodner's Firefly Pendant 260. Whoop-dee-doo, Joel, you are on a roll. Howard Cosell with your pendant update.
Scooch.
Thank you, Howard. Now let us continue the adventure.
Aw, are those monkeys?
Yeah, a whole mess of them.
Well then. This campus looks like it's seen better days. It's alright. One of the frats probably just had a party last night. They just let all the monkeys out of the science lab. I mean, that's... Everyone knows what happens when you let monkeys out of a science lab, right? It's harmless fun. No, wait, that's the plot of Rise of the Planet of the Apes. Also, 28 days later. Some sort of flash there. Some sort of in-game glitch. I wonder if Joel's life is at risk. The creator is warning him. Soon he's going to grab a sailboat and crash into an invisible skywall when Ed Harris comes over the loudspeaker and explains to him that his entire life has been a fabrication. John, you're just explaining the plot of The Truman Show. Yes, I am, and it's one of Jim Carrey's better movies. You should review it on movie night. All right, I will. Thanks. You're welcome. For those paying attention, yes, I did just have an entire conversation with an imaginary hotshot viewer. Health kits have been upgraded. 67% more effective, because now you know how to sterilize. Ooh, field medicine and emergency care procedures. So basically, Joel used alcohol to his advantage, rather than to get drunk. Although I would say both uses are commendable. And what else do we have here? Especially when you're at UEC, which I imagine is a party school. All schools in the mountains are probably party schools. My sister went to one in Vermont. Definitely a party school. Although she did learn to become a nurse. She's now making more money than I am. So, that's how that worked out. Ooh, what's this? More drugs. So, this was a fun visit. We found a training manual. And also stocked up on drugs and alcohol. Terrific. Hankersaw, there you are. Hippity hop. Get out of the way, little girl.
Boom. Scoot.
Come on, Scooch. Joel, no last name given. Wants to get back on this horse and giddy up so he can resurrect his singing career. Joel is a horseman.
Fireflies.
Wait, actual ones? A little symbol on the wall. Not actual ones.
I see it.
This is good. First sign of fireflies.
Scoot you on back.
I didn't want to get off. I wanted to initiate the optional conversation. There's the mirror building again. We're getting closer to it. There's another... No! Alright, so there's an optional conversation initiated when you look at these Firefly emblems. That one got all black and smudgy for some reason. But I believe I did initiate it. I think the optional conversation was just, I see it. So let's count that as completed and hope that I do end up getting the trophy at the end of this game, because the optional conversations are easy to miss sometimes.
All right.
I would say more so than some of the pendants or artifacts or whatever. Hop on off, Jolie. What's this here? Click, click.
There click, click.
Yeah, I can see it. It's the building we've been pointing out the whole time. Also,
bunch.
The generator is right there. Come on, why can't I activate the little triangle symbol? What is this? Was the game glitchy? Oh, there. I have to go right up against the fence to see
it. Another generator.
So close.
And yet, so far away.
Looks like they rigged this up as well.
Some sort of extension cord. Possibly for extending a cord.
Watch the horse. Why don't you watch the horse? Sorry, I'm just getting antsy.
Pipe down, little girl. You're just going through puberty or something. Probably, I don't know. I'm not a very good dad. My daughter died a long time ago. Oh, geez, I say that out loud and admit to all of my past transgressions. Broken television. At least they could use some of that tuition money on good things. Ooh, what do we have here? Oh, it's a UEC campus map. Press select to view. Well, let's zoom in, check it out. Getting slammed here. Must beef up barricades. Infected. Slipping through here. Need to reinforce something. Something. I can't read that. It's tough to read. I need a bigger television. Or I need to sit closer. Or they could just, print more legibly. Huh. That would be great. Are there any infected here? This is Joel, no last name given. Requesting assistance, UEC. Are there any infected here? There doesn't seem to be yet. Picked up some paper. The paper icon and the artifact icon are way too similar, in my opinion. Because the little paper icon looks exactly like you're about to pick up an artifact and read something important, contribute to the narrative of the story. But nope, it was just like a wad of toilet paper that Joel's going to use to wipe his ass next time he goes to the bathroom. But he never goes to the bathroom in this game. Perhaps some sort of genetic modification or side effect of all the infected is that people's assholes sealed up and they never have to go poop anymore. A compelling theory. I believe it requires more evidence. See? See, this is a student's journal. That looked the same as the last thing we picked up. Let's check it out. 9 goddamn months of waiting and still nothing. No word from anyone. Found some additional cans of food in the dining commons, but they won't last. Had an incident at the Eastern Hall barricade, but everything's still secure. See, right there. Had an incident. He probably attempted to poop, but ruptured his butthole. I caught a glimpse of a group of those things running around. Looked like Heather. Maybe it was Heather. Fuck. Maybe it was Heather. Fuck. See, if you read it differently, it changes the entire meaning of the sentence. Since batteries are running short, they're now only listening to the radio once a night. I gave up on that since the last broadcast. It's been 3 fucking months. Why do they bother? Because you want to hear my voice. Howard Cosell is the greatest broadcaster ever. Cheryl was smoking out yesterday. She was smoking? Damn. Cheryl, Heather, this guy has all the girls in his pocket. She said she needed it, but she got pissed when I threw out her stash. She doesn't get it. We need to keep a clear head here. Someone's going to have to get in town and get some more supplies, and it's probably going to have to be me. Wonder how long you held out? Probably not very long if you was into Savage Starlight. Those comics don't even seem that interesting. I don't know why Ellie keeps reading them. Probably because there's no other thing to keep her entertained in the post-apocalyptic zombie hellhole. You're right. That's probably the good enough reason. Ooh, a microwave in a dorm room. Ha, that brings back some memories. Dun, 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 dun. Look at all these clothes. These kids were slobs. Why am I crouching? All right. Nope.
Spores.
Spores? Oh, damn, that means probably infected around here. Let's stock up on our junk. I don't have a melee weapon. I can't create any more shivs. I can't create one of these. I can create a couple of cocktails. And another bomb. And another smoke bomb. So now I'm like maxed out. Which is kind of the curse of the easy playthrough. Is that you have an overabundance of supplies. And you actually can't pick up the materials. If you were to play this game on the harder survivor level difficulty. You would find that there's literally no supplies. And you'd be shit out of luck on most occasions. Okay, so there's a plume of spores coming out of the hole in the floor. That is the only place left to explore. So we march on assuredly to what is probably going to be a bad time for Joel. no last name given. Dun, 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 dun. Are those clickies? Clicky clackers? They all seem like it. If I can sneak up behind him and do a little shiv action. What's up, schmuck? What's up, Doc? Now, I feel like hand-to-hand melee shivy combat like that would put your little mask greatly at risk. Because you're grabbing this guy from behind, from the throat, there's a strong possibility that in that struggle, even if you do kill him, that your mask will become jostled and fall off your face, and then you will inhale some spores and end up just like these guys. I feel like when you're wearing a mask that can easily fall off and completely determines whether or not you yourself become infected, I feel like you'd want to be taking these enemies out at a safe distance rather than engaging them in such close proximity. But I guess it's better this way because you use less ammo, and of course it's way more entertaining. Stabbing them in the back, and oh my god, look at this. Man, that guy really needs to change his bed sheets. I went to school with a kid like that. Not even joking, this is kind of what his room looked like. He would routinely leave plates of food and soup and spaghetti half eaten on his desk in his dorm room for months at a time. Do you have any idea what uneaten food smells like in a college dorm room after 2 months of just being left out, mixed in with the smell of BO and underwear and just the general college dormitory smell? Disgusting is what it smells like. Completely disgusting. I can still smell it. Just, you know, access that memory file and boom. He was one of the... He wasn't my roommate, he was a suite mate, so I didn't have to share a room with him, but I did have to share a suite with this individual. His name was George, and he was by far the most disgusting individual I think I've ever met in my entire life. He left his room looking not unlike this infected shithole here. It was nasty. I was like, hey, I noticed somebody stole some of my ice cream, some of my food that I bought in the store last week. Where'd it go? It's in his room, uneaten, and just like spilled all over the floor. Like ice cream stains on the floor, packing peanuts and boxes everywhere. The sheet. Oh geez, that's a bloater. There were no sheets on his bed. He just slept right on the mattress and just had like blankets strewn about. All right, let's take this guy out. We're gonna throw a couple bombs at him. Take that, jerk! Oh, jeez! Killed him. He dropped a firefly. Wow, you killed a bloater and got yourself a present. Joe Warren's firefly pendant in stupendous rusted condition. The patina on this is first class. It's too bad you had to kill the guy wearing it, who was, in fact, a bloater. Howard Cosell with your pendant update. Thank you, Howard. That, I think, is the first time we've actually recovered an artifact directly off of a fallen infected like that. That's interesting. In so many of these games, you kind of expect that you kill a guy, you pick up their ammo. But it doesn't actually happen a lot in The Last of Us, and certainly not from the infected, which generally don't carry anything at all. And I'm just hypnotized by this my old roommate, George, probably built this little sculpture for us. Shit! What am I doing? I don't want to swing. I want to get out. Let me out of here. Come on. You can do it, Joel.
Squeeze that door.
So anyway, long story short, I went to a college. Not unlike this one. With a roommate that kept his room not unlike the infected hellhole we just walked through. And it was nasty. I only ever talked to the guy like twice all school year. But he just constantly reeked of like rotten eggs. Like it was like, you live like this? What is wrong? This is unsanitary. Just food, underwear, clothes, sheets, trash, and just general refuse just left everywhere. How he even had room to sleep or use his computer was beyond me. It looked like he just like, you know, cleared a spot every night when he would sleep, and then the next morning he would just throw shit back on the bed. It was not a way to go through life. Newspaper clippings, U.S. military effort recalls, U.S. military recalls search effort. Found this in town. What the fuck? No one's coming. Sorry, dude. But, I don't think people really care about some schmucky frat boy at UEC. They're probably going to want to save the scientists and the hot women before they get to you. That's just the truth. Excuse me, I had a burp there. Taking into the frat boy mentality quite well. Panty raid! Open up this door and raid some panties. Oh, that's it. Oh yeah, raid those panties. Actually, a woman's purse. Do women keep extra pairs of panties in their purses? I know I would. Because I'd constantly be getting wet all the time. I don't know what that... I guess I'm... If I was a girl, I would always be feeling at my own female organs. And constantly be in a state of arousal. I think that's what I was getting at with that joke, but it was very poorly formed. So, if you didn't entirely understand where I was going, I understand. And it's okay. Make no mistake. Not a very amusing person, and my jokes usually suck.
What? I think you're kind of funny.
No, I'm not.
More infected. I'm fine.
Here, come up on the gate.
I killed a bloater. His name was Joe Warren. And Howard Cassell paid a visit.
He paid you a visit without me?
Sorry, Ellie. It happens. I'm going to roll this over to the extension cord. And then I'm going to plug the extension cord into the generator. You go, look at that three-prong solution. Nice looking generator. It has a number of plugs for a number of different scenarios. Why does the generator start playing the Can-Can song? I don't know, don't matter.
Come on through.
Kind of a cool garage lift.
Scooch!
Joel has some stuff to do.
You think they were fireflies?
Oh, definitely. They had a pendant on him.
No. No, I don't think so.
Is Joel lying to Ellie?
How could they have infected so close to the lab?
Well, Bill used them as a form of defense. Maybe they're doing the same.
Yeah, I could see that.
Joel is just straight up lying to this little girl right now. He's like, oh yeah, yeah, yeah. No way they were fireflies. Oh yeah, protection. Yeah, no, I'm pretty sure I have realized it by this point, and I believe Joel has as well, that whatever fireflies were here at UEC have been completely, you know, overtaken and infected, and he doesn't want to completely dash Ellie's hopes yet, so he's just like, oh yeah, yeah, sure, yeah, they're still around. Yeah, no problem, little girl. We'll find you help. Yeah, I don't think so. I think we just be shit out of luck.
No, nothing.
Yeah, I'd expect to see someone by now. Let's get inside.
So there's the big mirrored building, which is known as the Richard Harrington Science Lab. I think we'll be fortunate enough to meet up with Richard Harrington and get a pendant from him. That would be pretty dope.
Unfortunately for now, for me, that does it for this episode of Game Time, but stay tuned for the next installment of The Last of Us Let's Play, where we go inside the science lab and find out where all the fireflies went to. As always, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.